When the news came across your desk back in January about Laing receiving that award, what was your reaction? I mean, obviously, I think you knew about Laing before. I guess they were the runners-up 2 years ago. So for this year, for them to receive that award for representing the state of South Carolina, just your thoughts, your reaction.
Well, it just affirms that we have great things going on in schools across South Carolina. Certainly, Laing is one of the leaders. And I'm excited about it because not only are the students and teachers benefiting from this type of teaching here, but other teachers across South Carolina can come and learn from what's going on here at Laing. So it's a great, wonderful pride that I feel.
What impressed you most about your visit today? You were just mentioning about the students and them showcasing their projects. What stood out to you most about your visit, either in the conversations or what you saw?
Well, a couple of things. Number one, every student I talked to said they love this school. Some had come from different experiences, but they love this school. Why? I love it because we interact. We do things here. It's not just sitting and learning, but it's up getting involved and doing things with our hands. And then secondly, how involved the girls were. We have a hard time getting girls involved in engineering jobs and mathematics, but these middle school girls outnumbered the boys, really, in the projects that I saw. So nothing to shine on the young men, but I'm so proud that the young women here at this school are so involved in mathematics and science.
You can't make every single middle school a carbon copy of itself across the state, but are there things that are in place here that are possible that could be placed in different middle schools around the state?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you're very fortunate to have this beautiful facility that was really built for this type of collaborative teaching and student engagement. But this can happen anywhere with paper plates in an old building. This is about teachers stepping back, engaging the students, letting the students define the problem, and come up with creative ideas. And it's okay if their first idea fails. It's about perseverance and trying, that there's more than one correct answer. So that can happen anywhere, and that's the message that I want to take to teachers across South Carolina.
What were you hoping to see that you got to see today? You heard about Laing and that you wanted to see?
Well, number one, that people here love coming to school, and middle school students loving coming to school, and they're excited about it. Students come to school in kindergarten and first grade with an enthusiasm for learning, and sometimes we stifle that, and by the time they're in middle school, they're not loving school anymore. But to see students really wanting to be here and knowing that every day that they're going to be engaged and having great activities where they're learning, that's what I hoped to see, and I definitely saw it here.
Also, for what your role is when it comes to education in our state, you're so involved in Columbia and lobbying on our behalf.
Yeah.
How rewarding is it to get out to different schools throughout the area? We love having you done your tours, but just to be able to get out to this, interact with the superintendents from the districts and interact with principals and teachers from the districts.
Well, it's hard, but we make a point to do it. And just today, I learned from the principal and the superintendent here. I asked, how can I help you? And they said, we have too many assessments and assessments that don't match what we're trying to teach here. Assessments that are bubble in rather than performance tasks, rather than students displaying what they know. I'm all for less assessments. I need to come out and hear that. It affirms what I'm trying to do in Columbia, to tell the legislature that we need to test less. We need to be accountable, but the accountability needs to be meaningful for the students and for the parents and teachers, and that's not what you get when you have too many bubble in tests. So that needs to change.
I'm just curious, when you interact with lawmakers and you have to present that argument, because some of them come from these business backgrounds where everything's cut and dry and education isn't cut and dry, especially public education, how do those discussions go and how do you present that so that they can understand what we're working with, what we're trying to accomplish?
Yeah, well, honestly, I think the legislators are getting that. They're hearing from parents and from teachers that there's too many assessments, that the assessments don't give the teachers the information they need. Sometimes we're our own worst enemies as educators. Sometimes, we've got to test in order for it to be important, but that's not true. The assessments need to match what are the students learning. And when we're telling students here at Laing that there's more than one correct answer or there's more than one way to get to the end solution, we need to allow them to show that in performance task assessments. We want to build those in South Carolina. It's going to take a while. Certainly, the teachers here at Laing need to be a part of that process and help us develop those type assessments for South Carolina.